You have become perhaps the loudest voice calling for impeachment. The Constitution sets the grounds for impeachment as treason, bribery, or other high crimes and misdemeanors. Which has the president violated?
Good morning, Dana. I would say it's clear that he has violated the Constitution in the sense that he has violated his trust with the American people through obstructing justice by firing the head of the FBI, Mr. Comey, for what he said explicitly was over the Russian investigation. He has been taking, in contradiction of the emoluments clause, he has been taking payments from foreign governments almost since the very first day that he took office. I don't think there's any question in it that he has, in fact, met that standard for impeachment. But I think the important thing is not just that he's met the standard, but it's very important and urgent that we get him out of office.
But the special counsel, Robert Mueller, and multiple congressional committees are in the middle of their investigations. Investigations, I should say, that President Trump calls a witch hunt. Aren't you playing into the president's message by calling for impeachment even before these investigations are complete?
As I said, an impeachment is actually a process where the House puts him up for a trial in the Senate. So, in fact, to have him impeached merely means that in a public way, the Senate goes through all of the evidence right in front of the American people. And the fact of the matter is, we know from what he said publicly that he has violated the Constitution and is subject to impeachment. There will be, inevitably, we're in favor of the Mueller investigation. God bless him for what he's doing. But the fact of the matter is, this president has performed in a lawless way throughout the campaign and throughout his presidency, and he is an urgent threat to the American people. So to sit here and wait, doing absolutely nothing, is the wrong thing to do. The American people want this man impeached.
I want to read to you what President Obama's former chief strategist, David Axelrod, tweeted. He said the following. He said, "Steyer impeachment ads seem to be more of a vanity project than a call to action. It is at least this point an unhelpful message. If impeachment becomes a political tool, it will be as damaging to our democracy as the degradations Donald Trump has inflicted on it." Your face is front and center in these ads. What some of your fellow Democrats are saying, as you just heard, is that you're using the specter of impeachment to build your own political brand. Your response?
I think that the people in Washington, D.C. and the political establishment can't accept the idea that the American people are supposed to have their own voice. And what we're doing is providing a venue for Americans to add their voices together to change the conversation, the dysfunctional conversation in Washington, D.C. That's what we're doing. And so, in fact, what we're trying to do is let the people's voice be heard, which is exactly what our organization has always done, is to go for more democracy. It doesn't surprise me that political elites want to close off the American people and make sure that they remain in control.
Mr. Steyer, you have, you're from California. You've said that you're considering running against the Democratic senator there, Dianne Feinstein, who's up for re-election next year. You two have a really different take and approach on President Trump. You're obviously calling for impeachment. She has called for patience on that issue. Would you do a better job as senator from California?
Well, I haven't said I'm considered running. What I said is I haven't ruled it out.
Is there a difference?
And the fact that I actually think there is, but
okay.
I don't want to split hairs with you on that subject. I think the main point is this. What we're trying to do, and what we would encourage Senator Feinstein to do too, is to actually look at what's going on the ground and to listen to the American people. Anyone who goes out, and I do this all the time, and listens to normal working people about what they're concerned about, know that they think there's a real problem in Washington, D.C., that it is not responsive to their needs, and there is something wrong with this administration that is dangerous to their health and safety on a daily basis, and in fact, we should be acting. So I urge Senator Feinstein to be much more urgent in the need for change than she is right now.
Briefly, where are you in your process of not ruling out a run for the Senate?
I don't need to rule it out. The fact of the matter is right now...
Are you going to run? Are you going to run? Do you think there's any chance that you're going to run?
I don't need to rule it out, and I can have time to think about it. The fact of the matter is, I am spending all of my time working to make sure that this petition gets as broad a listen as possible. And in addition, we are a huge grassroots organization registering, engaging, and mobilizing voters around the country. So I have a more than full-time job without running for any specific office.
I have to ask you about the other thing that you have done politically, and that is raise a lot of money and give a lot of money. You have said that the Democratic Party needs to get behind Bernie Sanders and his policies. But at the top of his agenda is limiting the influence of big money in politics. You were the biggest donor in the 2016 election cycle, giving over $91 million to Democrats. Are you a part of the problem that Bernie Sanders is working to fix?
Well, first of all, I'm absolutely in favor of changing the way that money is used in politics. And I think it is a huge problem, and I think it should be changed. Let me make two points. One, we try and do this in as transparent a way as possible, which is why I'm on your show right now, why I say everything that we're doing straightforwardly so people can look at me and gauge whether I'm telling the truth and why I'm doing it. And secondly, when you talk about spending that money is spent on going door to door and having citizens talk to citizens about the issues of the day. It spent registering over 1 million people in 2016 to make sure we get the broadest possible democracy. It's going on to 370 college campuses to talk to young people about the issues, to engage them so that they will involve themselves and see the importance in the political process. In fact, what our organization does is try and make sure every underrepresented group gets registered, engaged, and gets its voice in politics. So, in fact, we are trying to make the democracy as broad and strong as possible. If you want to change the way money works in politics, we're all behind you. We're working with the system we have right now as transparently and straightforwardly as possible.